one of my favorite things to do is to interview artists, and I've been really fortunate to interview a number of them, and some of my favorites were, you know, when I got to go to the Today Show, or when I went on the set of Homicide: Life on the Street, which is one of my favorite shows of all time, to go on the set of The West Wing, or to go on the set of ER and to meet the cast members. That was very exciting. And then I have other interviews that I define one category as like grand. And for me, grand is interviewing Ossie Davis, to talk to this man and to hear that voice and to hear so much wisdom come from him. I felt so fortunate to have met him. And to interview Maya Angelou, I've interviewed her maybe a half a dozen times. And each time, I just feel so blessed to be in her presence. And I remember one time sitting in her kitchen, and while we were waiting for the photographer to set up, and she was just talking about how she did her work. And I just had one of those wow moments where I just thought, isn't this grand? I'm sitting here talking to Maya Angelou. And so that's one of the things that just makes this job so special. And then I have what I call the giggle moments. When I was a kid, one of the things I did that I could have gotten in trouble for, it was a movie that came out called Shaft. And everybody was talking about Shaft and how the character of this movie was so cool. Well, I wasn't old enough to go see Shaft. And so my friends and I decided that we would put our hair in a French roll and we'd put makeup on and we'd go to the movie theater and we would see Shaft. And we got in and it was great. And then fast forward years later, and here I am, sitting talking to Richard Roundtree, and it's like, this is awesome. And he was just so down to earth, and that was a great moment. Another great moment, as a kid, I always watched Art Linkletter. And Art Linkletter came to town for the Children's Home Society to speak to one of their dinners, and I sat next to him and got the chance to interview him. And to see a 91-year-old man stand and talk for 45 minutes in the most engaging manner, it was just special. And so, and you see why I have the best job in the world. I really do.